Alright everybody, I'm here back underneath the F600, haven't done too much with it in about the last 2.5-3 weeks. I went back to work 2.5 weeks ago, so I've been dealing with that and had a lot of rain, and if it hasn't been raining, it's been high 80s, low 90s, mid 90s. And I just don't feel like coming out here working on this after I've been outside in the sun all day. But I figured I'd at least show you what I got done with the Ramsey 15,000 pound PTO winch. If you guys go back into, well, I think it's part one, where I cut the abomination off of the transmission cross member. I talked to you guys about putting a piece of pipe up there. Well, I had to go a little farther than what I anticipated. So, that's where the pipe I ended up putting in there. It's a piece of 4-inch. I thought about going with 3-inch, but it didn't quite suit my needs. Clearances were going to be a little closer to my liking. Right now that's just tacked in place. I still got to finish weld it. I had originally planned on let's see if I got a better view from the front. There we go. Now this transmission cross member originally came right about there and started to bend up, just like the passenger side there. So I finished doping the frame out real nice, cleaned it all up, got this piece of pipe up in here, tacked it, and I started to install the PTO shaft and the slip coupler, or the slip yoke, I should say, and it just didn't want to cooperate. I had enough clearance at the front, or it comes out underneath the radiator support. It cleared everything, but it didn't want to mate up with the PTO back here. That was a twofold issue. First one, I forgot. Now you guys look at that PTO box. Your engine and transmission don't sit level in a vehicle. It sits pitched back for driveline angle going to your rear axle. I forgot to take that into account. So that pitches your PTO output up in the air. Well, I got this in with the transmission cross member just coped, but it didn't want to play nice with the pipe here. So I cut that back out, put the PTO coupler, slip yoke, and shaft back in, and it still didn't want to spin. I got digging around a little bit more, looked at the old slip yoke that was originally on here, and there wasn't a grease circ in it. So that tells me that, you see that grease circ right there? Well, as this spun around, it contacted the bottom of the transmission cross member and broke it off. Or they took it out after it broke off. So I ended up having to completely cut the transmission cross member and then cut it back farther, cope it here, cope it up there, put the pipe in, and I had to kick the pipe instead of being perpendicular to the transmission cross member. I had to kick it a little bit like that, so I have enough room to be able to slide this yoke onto the PTO shaft. And then because of that, because of the angle that all of that's on, you guys can see it from back here. I'll go out and around and show you what I did up there. But I had to lower the winch down. And I still have an inch and a half of clearance between the bottom of the PTO shaft and the top of the axle more than what it is from the top of the bump stop to the bottom of the frame. So I'm not worried about the axle compressing and hitting the PTO shaft. Either, you know, driver side wheel up or passenger side wheel up or being at full compression on both, I'm still going to have at a minimum an inch of clearance between bottom of the PTO shaft and the top of the axle housing. So no worries there. I gotta finish welding that out. I did check it for operation. The forward and reverse function of the PTO shaft or PTO box does work. The winch does work. It rotates forward, it rotates reverse. Obviously, it wasn't under power. There's no cable on it, but it does spin freely. I greased that, put all new oil in it. But as you guys can see, now that was cut out. These were flipped around the other way, and I had to flip them back around the way I originally wanted to mount this. So kind of happy about that, because if you guys look across here, when I build the bumper for this, just top of the frame rail, that's where the top of the checker plate's going to be. And I'm going to clear the entire body of the winch, which is great because when I do this, I'll make a cutout to access the winch, put a locking handle on it so I can either open it up this way or open it up that way, or I might do a bifold. So it's easier for spooling the cable on, doing routine maintenance. You know, all the fun stuff nobody wants to do. So I at least got that done. Still haven't quite figured out what I'm going to do for a bumper. I'll probably end up just doing three pieces of channel iron. I'll do one here down on the front. I don't know how high I'm going to go with it yet. I got to order a roller fairlead, get that mounted, or see how it's going to mount, and then make my decision from there about the front piece of channel iron. I would like to come down low enough that I cover the brake right there. So in case there is a front end impact, I don't have to worry about
destroying the worm gear or the brake on the winch. And out the side, whatever that ends up being, I may go the full height, which I think is around 12 inches. Or I may do a step up with the same size channel iron here. Just step it up to the top of the frame, and then I'll add a piece in down here to make it more of a smooth transition. This way it won't look as janky. And then the only other thing is the angle. It's coming from here. If I'm going to go a sharp angle, or if I'm going to do a more of a wider angle coming back and then go back, because I was thinking about it, and then one of my subscribers asked if I was going to incorporate toolboxes here into the front, which I may do. So if I do it as a less steep angle, I can have a fairly decent sized built-in toolbox for chains or cables, shackles, other rigging hardware, snatch blocks. So I still got to figure out what I want to do with that. So I'm going to be bouncing around between this and working on this trailer. I got to do some maintenance on this. I got to do, got to add some things to it that I've been meaning to add to it. I built this trailer, I think, 12 years ago. So the actual deck part of this trailer is 8.5 foot wide, and it's 20 foot long. Plus the beaver tail. Last year I finally got around to adding some reverse lights on it. Still got to wire those in. I bought some more of those so I can put work lights up here at the front. I got to figure out where I want to put those at. Haven't entirely figured that out yet. But I got to get all this done before the end of July, because I'm going on a long parts run. Made a deal with a guy for some parts, and he's quite a distance away. But, you guys are going to have to wait until I go down and get it to find out what that is. So in the upcoming weeks, I'll be spending some time working on this, making sure it's up to snuff for a long haul. And we'll see what else I can get done on this whole thing. I'm waiting on brake parts to come in yet for the Hydro Boost swap. I'm having issues getting parts to actually show up in a timely manner. Some of the stuff I ordered 3 weeks ago and I'm still waiting for it. But it is what it is. I also found some cool literature and other parts for this truck and my 79 F700. I'll probably end up doing a video on some of that stuff. But, yeah, we'll see what happens here in the next month and a half. I'll do my best to keep you guys updated on all of it, but me going back to work kind of leaves my free time at a minimum. Yeah, and I've got other prior engagements I have to attend to, so we'll see what happens. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.